Hello friends, welcome to our channel tutel.com. So today we are going to discuss about fundamental theorem of arithmetic. Let's start. So what is this fundamental theorem of arithmetic? So basically every natural number can be expressed as a product of its prime numbers. So these prime numbers, their order is very much unique, and that is why this theorem is also known as unique prime factorization theorem. Okay, let's understand more about this theorem by examples. So this question usually comes for 2 marks in CBSE. It's important. Show that 12 raised to power n cannot end with digit 0 or 5 for any natural number n. So we know that if a number ends with 0 or 5, it must have 5 as a factor. That means it should be divisible by 5. So if 12 raised to power n ends with 0 or 5, then it must have 5 as a factor. So how can you write 12? What are the prime factors of 12? So it is written as 2 into 2 into 3 whole raised to power n. So this 2 is occurring 2 times. So this is 2 raised to power 2n into 3 raised to power n. That means only prime factors of 12 raised to power n are 2 and 3. Fine. And from fundamental theorem of arithmetic, we know that these prime factorization is unique. Prime factorization of each number is unique. That means 12 raised to power n cannot have 0 or 5. So if it cannot have 0 or 5 as a factor, then it will never end with digit 0 or 5. Fine. I hope this step is clear to you. So if you solve your answer till this point, you will get 1 mark. And for this point, you will get another 1 mark. Okay. So just think about this. Can the number 4 raised to power n being a natural number, end with digit 0? Give reason. So if you have any doubt in this question, just try to solve this question. If you have any doubt, please post your query in your comment section and we'll solve it out. Okay. Find the LCM and HCF of 96 and 360 and verify that LCM into HCF is equal to product of two numbers. So you are already aware what is HCF and what is LCM. HCF is product of, you have to take the common factor, and then of that common factor you have to take the smallest power. Fine. So product of the smallest power of each common factor. So let's try to solve. So first of all, you need to find the prime factors of the given numbers. So 96 can be written as 2 raised to power 5 into 3. Fine. How will you find the prime factors using this method like you were doing in class 6? Fine. 96. So you can just find the factors using this method. So it is written as 2 raised to power 5 into 3. 360 can be written as 2 raised to power 3 into 3 square into 5. Now what is this HCF? HCF is highest common factor. Fine. So you have to take the common factors first. So out of these factors, 2 is occurring here also and here also. So 2 is common, and then you have to take the smallest power. So this will be 2 raised to power 3, and from 3 and 3 square, smallest power is 3 raised to power 1. So HCF will be 2 raised to power 3 into 3 raised to power 1, which is 24. Fine. So moving over to LCM. LCM is, for LCM you have to take all the factors but with the greatest power. So we have 2, greatest power out of 5 and 3 is 5. So this will be 2 raised to power 5, and then you have to take the product also. Out of 3, we have 3 square and 5 is alone, so 5 raised to power 1. So when you will multiply this, you'll get 1440. So this is HCF and LCM. If this question comes for 3 marks, you'll get 1 mark for HCF and 1 mark for LCM. Next part of the question says, so you're already aware, for two numbers, LCM of two numbers A and B into HCF of two numbers A and B is equal to product of two numbers, which is A into B. So we have to verify this. LCM into HCF is equal to product of two numbers. So let's solve LHS part first. LHS is LCM into HCF. LCM is 1440 into HCF is 24. So answer is 34560. Product of two numbers. So two numbers are 96 and 360. Once you multiply it, you'll get 34560. So these two are same. LHS is equal to RHS, hence verified. So you'll get another one mark for this step. I hope this question is clear to you. you can visit to our website for LCM, for the relation of LCM and HCF for three numbers. Okay, so this part is very important. We always get confused where we have to find LCM and where we have to find HCF. So let's see. Basically, you just have to understand the concept first. LCM is least common multiple. So whenever we say multiple, like if I say multiple of 2, multiple of 2 will be 2, 4, 6, 8, 10 and so on. That means multiple of any number will be greater than that number or equal to that number. Fine. So minimum is that number, least. Fine. HCF. HCF is highest common factor. So whenever we say factor, supposedly we say factors of 6. Factors of 6 will be 1, 2, 3 and 6. Fine. So factors of any number will be that number and less than that number. Factors will also be less than that number. Fine. But multiples will always be greater than that number or equal to that number. So whenever this word minimum or least is given to you, you have to find LCM. Or whenever we have to find a number which is larger than the given number, whenever some numbers are given to you and you need to find some number which are larger than the given number, you will find LCM. Similarly, whenever word maximum is given to you or you have to find a number which is smaller than the given number, you'll find HCF. So this concept will be more clear to you by these examples. So first example says, find the least number which when divided by 6, 15 and 18 leaves same remainder 5 in each case. Okay, so in this case we need to find a number which is divisible by 6, 15 and 18. So we have to find some number which is divisible by 6 also, 15 also and 18 also. So obviously we cannot think of a number which is less than these numbers. Fine. A smaller number, we cannot think of some number which is less than 15 and it is divisible by 18 also. Fine. So the number which we need to find should be greater than 6, 15 and 18. So it will be larger than the given number. So we will find LCM. Let's see second example. So two tankers contain 750 and 580 liters of petrol respectively. Find the maximum capacity. So by this word maximum, we will understand that we have to find HCF. Okay, let's read the question. Maximum capacity of a container which can measure the petrol of both the tankers when used an exact number of times. That means we have two tankers. One tanker is of capacity 750 liters. Second tanker is of capacity 580 liters. So we have to find the maximum capacity of a container which can measure the petrol of both the tankers. So we need another container, let it be a mug, which can measure the petrol of both the tankers. So that means we need the container whose size will be smaller than the given tankers. Okay, size of the given tanker. So we'll find HCF. Okay, next example. In an evening walk, three persons step off together. Their step measure 80 centimeters, 75 centimeters and 90 centimeters respectively. What is the minimum distance each should walk so that all can cover the same distance in complete steps? Minimum distance each should walk so that all can cover the same distance. Like first person covers 80 centimeters. Second person will cover 75 centimeters. So third person will cover 90 centimeter. So we need to find the minimum distance each should walk so that all can cover the same distance. Same distance, that means that number should be greater than all these three numbers. So we'll find LCM. Okay, let's understand this question. This question is very, very important. Six bells commence to get tolling together and toll at intervals of 2, 4, 6, 8 and 12, 8, 10 and 12 seconds respectively. In 30 minutes, how many times do they toll together, excluding the one at start? So we have six bells which will toll together at an interval of 2, 4, 6, 8, 10 and 12 seconds. So in 30 minutes, we have to find in how many times they will toll together. So let's understand the concept first. Let's consider two bells first, okay? So let's consider that they toll after every 3 seconds and 4 seconds. This means the first bell will toll after every 3, 6, 9, 12 seconds and so on. Likewise, the second bell will toll after every 4, 8, 12 and so on seconds. So that means first time they will toll together is at 12 seconds. So after 12 seconds, they will toll again. Fine. This 12 second is nothing, but if you see, it is the LCM of 3 and 4. Fine. So this was just to understand you, make you understand the concept. You don't have to write. So from here you will start your solution. So to find the time when they all will total together, we have to find the LCM of the given numbers. So 2 can be written as 2 raised to power 1, 4 can be written as 2 raised to power 2, 8 can be written as 2 raised to power 3, 6 can be written as 2 raised to power 1 into 3 raised to power 1, 10 can be written as 2 raised to power 1 into 5 raised to power 1, 12 can be written as 2 raised to power 2 into 3. That means LCM, what is this LCM? You have to find all the factors with greatest power, product of all the factors. So 2, one factor is 2, highest power is 2 raised to power 3. Into highest power of 3 is 1 only, and highest power of 5 is 1. So this will give you 120 seconds, and 120 seconds is 2 minutes. So after every 2 minutes, all the bells will toll together. For example, in 10 minutes, they toll together in 5, how many times? 5 times, okay? So that is after 2, 4, 6, 8, 10 minutes. It does not include the one at the start. So in 30 minutes, they will toll together how many times? 30 upon 2, which is 15 times, excluding the one at the start. So I hope this question is clear to you. Let's just summarize what we have just learned. So this fundamental theorem of arithmetic, we have every composite number can be expressed as a product of its prime. So for example, 36 can be written as 2 into 2 into 3 into 3. What are the applications? It is used to find HCF and LCM. So there are two methods of finding HCF. One is using this long division method, which is known as Euclid's division algorithm. Second one is fundamental theorem of arithmetic. So this HCF is nothing but product of smallest power of each common prime factor in the number. And LCM is nothing but the product of greatest power of each prime factor in the number. So for two numbers, HCF into LCM is equal to product of two numbers. And for three numbers, LCM is equal to PQR, product of three numbers into HCF of three numbers upon HCF of P and Q, HCF of Q and R, HCF of R and P. Likewise, you can find HCF of three numbers also. In place of LCM, you will write HCF, and in place of HCF, you will write LCM. Fine. So I hope this topic is clear to you. Please don't forget to subscribe and like this video. And don't miss any science and maths video that we are uploading. Visit our website www.utel.com for more educational videos, to try online tests related to the topic, and to get the best quality of study material and much more. Stay safe, stay healthy. Wait for the next video. Thank you.